Thank you for the opportunity to present to you today. This is Adriana. She is 80 years old. She has 11 grandkids and 4 great-grandkids. Adriana has severe knee arthritis. She visits Banff regularly and is used to climbing Sulphur Mountain on every visit. She's no longer able to do it. Her heart is willing, but her knees will not allow it, and Adriana is frustrated. Adriana is one of almost 6 million Canadians suffering from arthritis. Currently, that is 1 in 5 Canadians, but by 2040, that number increases to 1 in 4. Women are 1.5 times more likely to have knee arthritis than men. Adriana needs to have her knees replaced, but in Canada, the odds of her family doctor referring her to an orthopedic surgeon would be double if she were a man. A man who presented with the exact same symptoms and the exact same x-rays as Adriana's. Once she does get in to see that orthopedic surgeon, the chance that that surgeon would offer her a knee replacement would be 22 times greater if she were a man. These disturbing numbers hold true despite the fact that when the physicians were asked if patient sex had any influence on their decision, they said it did not. For Adriana, the fact that she is female is a barrier to her getting excellent orthopedic care. This is in Canada, and Adriana is my mother. More than half of the population in Canada is female, and half of our medical school classes are women. When we look at orthopedic surgeons in Canada, though, only 12% are female. This is one of the lowest rates of women among the surgical specialties. So even though orthopedic surgeons serve a diverse population, our numbers are not diverse. Why is diversity so important? Diversity in a group brings different points of view, which leads to new ideas and creative solutions. Diverse groups are more innovative, they're happier, they're more creative, and ultimately more successful. Translating this to orthopedics, a diverse group of surgeons will be able to better understand their patients and therefore better able to provide excellent care. This discrepancy is most obvious for gender, but it holds true for all other minorities and becomes even more substantial when intersectionality is present. Until the orthopedic surgeons in Canada reflect the diversity of our patient population, our patients will not receive the best care possible. The solution starts with addressing the gender gap in Canadian orthopedic surgery. Why are there so few women in orthopedics? Is there a hidden curriculum steering them away from the specialty? Can women not imagine doing orthopedics because they see no female mentors to lead the way? Is it true that girls just don't like power tools? We need to know the precise barriers that women face entering an orthopedic profession so we can understand how to achieve equity. Equity where everyone has the opportunity to succeed and systematic barriers do not hinder the advancement of qualified individuals. Improving diversity will require a bold and a comprehensive plan that incorporates systematic and intentional steps to address gender inequity. The first step will be to identify and name the barriers that exist for women in Canadian orthopedics. Identified barriers can then be researched and collaborative strategies formulated to dismantle them. Leaders in academic institutions, provincial and national organizations will be engaged and equipped as catalysts to effect meaningful change. Finally, grassroots culture change will be encouraged by providing education and system improvements that support gender equity. This will be a multi-year longitudinal project and consequently a large budget venture. Step one will identify the barriers and provide comprehensive insight into the experiences of women in Canadian orthopedics. A gender bias survey with correlations to job satisfaction and burnout will be conducted, along with an opportunity for women to share their experiences working in orthopedics. For $10,000, we can fund this foundational step in the research process. The information gathered in this step will inform all of the subsequent projects, collaborations, and strategies. We all want to take excellent care of our patients. The medical system that we've been trained in is steeped in history and tradition. Unfortunately, some of that tradition includes discrimination against women and minorities. Understanding and providing system-wide solutions to this problem is the responsibility of everyone in our profession. Success of this initiative will depend on the collaboration and buy-in from male allies, leaders, and those with privilege to be powerful advocates for change. The UFC Eyes High strategic plan states that they are committed, and I quote, to removing barriers that have been and continue to be encountered by equity-seeking groups, including women and other minorities. The data from this project will be the catalyst for improving equity within orthopedics, but most importantly, ultimately for our patients. Over the last few years, there has been some headway towards improving gender equity in Canadian orthopedics. The progress, however, is slow, and it's not transformational. Our goal is for orthopedic surgery to be a specialty, where women have the same opportunity as men, where barriers specific to gender and race do not exist. We want our surgeons of tomorrow to not have to face the same historical challenges. Most importantly, though, we want our patients, like Adriana, to have excellent orthopedic care that has no bearing on their gender or race, because Canadian orthopedic surgeons look like and understand their patients. If we can do this for orthopedics, we can pave the way for all of the surgical specialties. Thank you.